Hey Eco Explorers, my name is Liesl Erb and I am the Mammalogy Science Mentor for the Eco Explorer program. I'm so excited to tell you about why I love mammals and Eco Explorer and the role you can have today. I am a professor of conservation biology at Warren Wilson College. That's a lot of words, right? Professor of conservation biology. It means I care about the natural world and I work with other people to figure out how to protect it and keep it here for future generations just like yours. And I teach my students about mammals. I research mammals myself. I teach classes like mammalogy, but I also teach classes like ecology. I study how all of our ecosystems work together and all the parts of them work together. I'm one of those people that has connected with the natural world and loved nature since the very beginning. I'm from the state of Idaho, which is really far from North Carolina, but it actually has a lot in common with North Carolina. Just like North Carolina has all these ecosystems, from the coastal marshes into deciduous forests, into conifer forests like pine, spruce, fir forests, all the way up to our top 6,000 foot peaks with grassy balds on top. Idaho has a lot of different ecosystems too. I grew up in the desert, sagebrush, scrub, but my family loved to go into the mountains. We would go into and camp by a mountain lake or in a conifer forest with spruce and fir, just like here. And in those places, I learned to love to listen to nature. Sometimes, it downright scared me. When I was a kid, I have this vivid memory of camping with my family at our family property. And I woke up in the middle of the night out of a dead sleep to what I swear was coyotes 2 inches from the door of the tent. I was so scared. I was like, they're right there, Dad. Am I gonna be okay? No, 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 it's okay, Liesl. They're actually quite far away. They're across the meadow. Their voices just carry, right? And that idea of voices carrying is something that I have carried with me through my career, because I've realized that if we just listen, mammals are telling us the story of their ecosystems. Those coyotes in that meadow tell me that there's enough food for them. They're in a pack, they're doing their coyote thing. When we see mammals, when we hear mammals, they're telling us the stories if we listen. And that's what I hope you'll do in this Mammalogy badge, is listen, pay attention to the mammals and the stories they have to tell. I've tried to do that throughout my whole career. When I got my PhD, which is how I became Dr. Liesl Erb, I studied in the state of Colorado, and I was studying this little animal called a pika. It's a small mammal, it's a rabbit relative that lives in rock slopes way up in the high mountains, above 9,000 feet. And it is really a voice of the mountains. It makes this iconic and when it makes that call, it's actually not telling us what's going on with the ecosystem directly. It's saying, get out of my territory. I have food here and you are infringing on that. But they also are telling us whether or not that ecosystem's okay. What my research was doing was looking into why pikas were in some mountain ranges but had disappeared from others. The answer is usually something going on with the plant community, with predator communities, with diseases that might be affecting them. And a lot of it has to do with climate change. So I was there finding out what the pikas had to say about their ecosystem. Mammals are in every ecosystem on the planet. They can be in all those places because they make their own heat, right? Mammals are so special. They're good voices for ecosystems because they're in all of them. And they often play really important roles. Because they make their own heat, they can be out in the winter, they can be up in the Arctic when it's really hard. A salamander has to go way down and stay underground and protected in the winter because it can't make its own heat, but mammals can. Because of that, they have so much to tell us if we just pay attention. The other way that I love to study mammals is with camera traps. They are an amazing way to tap into the secret lives of mammals that we don't necessarily see any other way. I hope that some of you get the chance to use them. I know that one of the prizes for Eco Explorer is a camera trap, so rack up those points and win that. What's cool is you can set up a camera in your backyard and find out what they're up to at night. Many mammals have so many amazing adaptations to being out at times that we don't see them. So they have good night vision, they have that good warm fur coat that allows them to be out at night. And what are they up to? In your very backyard, do you even realize there could be bobcats in your backyard? And if you see a bobcat, that means there's enough food for them and enough food for their food, which is a really good sign for the ecosystem. So I'm so excited to be your mammalogy mentor. I can't wait to see what mammalogy field season holds, what mammal stories you collect and share with me throughout the field season. Get out there, eco explorers. Good luck, have fun, and keep exploring.